You can't possibly have avoided the hype surrounding the release of the new Apple iPhone 15 running iOS 17, which should be dropping onto people's doormats as we speak. In the usual fashion, Apple stores have had lengthy queues outside, and rumour has it that Apple have been struggling to meet the demand for the new iPhone 15 and iPhone 15 Max. So the big question is, what's so exciting about it? Today I'll run through Apple's 7 incredible hearing accessibility features built into iOS 17 that are specifically geared up to make life easier for anybody out there with hearing loss. Plus, there's one feature that Android devices have that I'm desperate for Apple to adopt to. So kicking off today's list, we first of all have Apple's Made for iPhone hearing aid feature. Now, whilst this isn't a new feature, it has dramatically shifted the way we look at hearing aids for the last decade now, allowing your hearing aids to connect directly to your iPhone, thus eliminating any issues that you may have hearing somebody on the other end of your phone. And in my opinion, this is advantageous for 2 different reasons. Firstly, it means that when you're answering your phone or listening to the radio, music or podcasts, in fact, any audio whatsoever, that sound will be directed to both of your hearing aids, just like a wireless set of headphones. However, not just any wireless headphones, but a set of wireless headphones on steroids. As not only does the iPhone 15 stream the sound directly to your hearing aids, but it also takes into account your hearing loss too, personalizing the sound for you. The second advantage of having a direct connection with your hearing aids is that each hearing aid manufacturer also has their own app to work with your iPhone. This allows you to manually control the settings on your hearing aids, including adjusting basic features such as volume or frequency response, i.e. the bass, mids or treble, to even using AI-based features to adjust the sound of the hearing aids based on your specific environment. If, on the other hand, you don't have hearing aids just yet, then this next feature will absolutely blow your mind, and you may already have everything that you need to make it work. I am such a huge fan of this headphone accommodation feature that I already have 2 videos on YouTube covering it. When enabled, it's possible to use your iPhone 15 to personalize the outputs of your headphones specifically for your hearing loss. Yep, you heard me correctly. You can easily perform a basic hearing test using an app such as the Mimi Hearing Test app, or you can even upload your hearing test results from an audiology appointment directly to the health app in your iPhone. And then any sound produced by your headphones will be tailored specifically for your hearing loss. Taking this one step further, if you have the AirPods Pro, then you can also activate the transparency mode, which Apple boasts will boost softer speaking people to within your audible range and help to control the environmental sounds around you too. In my opinion, these features, combined with the next few features in this video, will transform your ability to hear on your iPhone. The next iOS 17 accessibility feature designed to make your life easier if you have a hearing loss is Apple's Live Listen feature. If you've ever been to a lecture or tried to hear somebody amongst the cacophony of background noise in a restaurant, then this is definitely the feature for you. Live Listen turns your iPhone into a remote microphone, which, when activated, sends the sound that it picks up from your environment directly to any connected devices, such as hearing aids or headphones. So imagine that you're in a lecture and you're struggling to hear the person speaking. You can take your phone and place it next to them, and it will transmit the sound directly to your AirPods Pro, or Made for iPhone connected hearing aids. I mean, I have to say that it's pretty cool that all of this is already built into your iPhone. So we've all been there, waiting for that important message or call. And then you put your phone down for a split second, and of course, that's the time that it chooses to ring. Visual alerts is so basic, yet such a powerful tool for anybody with hearing loss. When activated, the LED on the back of your iPhone or iPad Pro will blink when you receive a notification on your phone. So a flashing light, in combination with you feeling your phone vibrate, means that you should never miss a call again. Next up, we have the real-time text, or RTT feature, which, in my opinion, is a great tool to support those who really struggle to hear on the phone and just need a little extra help. It allows you to text and also receive text messages in real time. Now, you're possibly thinking, well, what's new about that? We can already send text messages. Well, you're right and you're wrong at the same time. RTT messages come through in real time, and as they're being physically typed, this means that you can actually see the words appearing on screen in front of you. In fact, you can see the letters appearing on screen in front of you. Therefore, it's even faster and has a more authentic feel to it than a standard text message, which you would only see when a whole message has been written and then the send button has been pressed. To make this feature even better, Apple also saved the transcription in the call log on your phone for you to look back at so you can remember all these conversations that you've had. Communication as a whole is made up of vision, context, and hearing. And if you suffer with hearing loss, then you'll be far more reliant on visual clues, i.e. lip reading, and also contextual information, such as the clues within a sentence. Of course, on a regular phone call, you don't have that flexibility and all of that information, so video calls are pretty standard now, allowing you to not only hear, but also read the lips of the person speaking to you. If, of course, you use sign language, then of course this is even more of an essential feature for easy communication. With thousands of things to watch on Apple TV nowadays, it is a strong contender with Netflix and Amazon Prime. And in today's world, it would be pretty archaic to not include closed captions or subtitles, as is the case with some streaming services. With the press of a few buttons, you can set up your Apple TV to display subtitles as default and choose from an array of different languages. This feature, paired with both made for iPhone hearing aids or the headphone accommodation feature, means that you should never miss a word of your favorite TV show again. Live Captions is a feature which is currently available on some Android devices and that Apple are currently trialing on beta, and I hope for everybody watching this video that they make it available for iOS 17. When activated, this adds captions to any media being played on your iPhone. So that's whether it's a video sent from your grandchildren, a podcast, phone call, or even a live video call without its own closed captions, you will see live closed captions displayed on the screen. So come on Apple, let's catch up with Android and make this dream a reality. So guys, I would love to know what you think to Apple's accessibility features in the comments beneath this video. And even more importantly, let me know what you think is missing. Now, check out these videos for how to set up your AirPods Pro with headphone accommodations to use them as hearing aids. Thanks for making it this far, and I'll see you in the next video.